time, and that was an 0 for 1.
No.
I do.
Back in the way comes Marchand, cuts in time, scores! David Pastrnak!
And it's almost a replica, sloppy in the middle. This is the best line, one of the best lines in the National Hockey League, and you're handing the puck over to them. Marchand comes right down the middle of the ice. He never even broke stride. That is so hard for the defenseman to defend that.
Chara drives it off with Carlson's stick. Pastrnak tries to throw it in front. Marchand is locked up with Couture. There's going to be a lot of room on. We get a look at the contact behind the net. Marchand standing up for himself. Didn't like the contact by Couture. Even though the gloves come off, I don't think there'll be a fighting major here.
Well, Couture's down the tunnel, and so is.
Here comes Marchand trying to control that Bergeron pass, and the wraparound hit the post, they score! Bergeron jammed it in front, and that Bruin top line opens the scoring.
They had a 3-0 lead over Pittsburgh and lost it, but still won 6-4. They were down 3-1 to Montreal on Tuesday in the first, tied it. Then lost 5-4. Here we go. Marchand and Hronek.
Hronek. Of all people. But I guess if you want to get a guy off the ice, you want to get Marchand off.
It's a good trade-off.
Well, I'd say.
Hronek's pretty valuable.
No disrespect to Hronek, right.
Yeah. Don't lick him. Don't lick him.
There's only one Marchand, though. That's the deal. Marchand took a run at Hronek.
Boston penalty 63. 5 minutes each for fighting.
There's a look at the start of it. There wasn't much really going on. Just a little bit of contact here and there, but Marchand decided, okay, let's go. I think that's the last thing that Bruce Cassidy wants Marchand to be doing, is fighting, and ended up spending 5 minutes in the penalty box.
Back of his goal, whips, the score by Marchand. Petrie just lost control of the puck, and Brad Marchand has his 600th
NHL center. Other than that, they've been close all season long.
They lead the league in shots. They take almost 35 shots a game, but their shooting percentage is not that good. So that ends up, all that doesn't work out to anything, as Petrie and Marchand are going
to have a
dance.
Fight. It was quick. Petrie and Brad Marchand.
Came to fruition. The finish behind the net. Marchand gets up, grabs his stick, little shove, little cross check, back and forth, slash, spear. There were about 8 penalties going on all in about 10 seconds. You might as well throw them.
Down low now in front of shot, they score. It's Marchand. Brad Marchand just picked it up and put it home, and it's 1-0 Boston.
To keep that 1-0.
It sure was, and you don't usually see
Marchand. 2 for cross-checking.
Body may have took a stick up high as he had a comment for the referee. Now Marchand scores!
Late goal, just over a minute left. Little play down low, Marchand just gets lost. Doesn't get all of that puck. Bit of a roller that just goes under the right arm of Marc-Andre Fleury.
He slings it toward the slot. Wow! Oh my gosh! That was a rope-a-dope special by Marchand. 2 goals for Brad Marchand in the third period, about 2 feet apart. And Marchand, Marchand gives a beating and a lesson, making Danish pastry out of Nikolaj Ehlers.
You want to come at me, you want to challenge me, we're going to take this right to the end.
Marchand must score to keep the game going. Marchand overskates the puck. He touched it, though, with his stick. What's the ruling? The officials get together.
He moved it forward.
If he touched the puck with his stick, that's going to count.
He did move it forward.
What an ending this would be. Flyers are off the bench, but there's been no call made yet. No goal! It's over! Marchand flubs it! And the Flyers win in the shootout. 6-5 is your final. I'm not sure these fans can have any sweeter an ending than that.
Unbelievable. Watch him just touch the top of the puck. Barely. Oh, moves it. 2 inches, and that'll do it. If he misses it, he can regroup and come back at it. He makes just a little contact. He knows it. And this one